Steve Dotto here. Today I want to talk to you about Gmail, about getting more productivity out of Gmail. Now there's lots of tips online about how to organize your folders and different practices you can do within Gmail that will help you become a little bit more efficient. And we should strive to be more efficient in our email software because that's where we spend so much time. I want to show you something today a little bit more off the beaten path. Now, for years, Google has tried out new features in something called Google Labs. We used to find it right on the landing page within our Google landing page. We'd click on Labs and it would show us all the different little skunkworks things that they were working on that we could install in our different Google applications. Now, lately, Google's hidden that away. It's not quite as loud and proud anymore. And a lot of people think it's disappeared, but it's still a great place to go to find additional functionality that you can add to your accounts or to your services like Gmail. So this is how you go about finding it. You just open your Gmail account in your browser, and then if you go into your settings, you can go and you can find right there Google Labs available as one of the menu items in your general settings. When we click on that, they tell us right away, it's some crazy experimental stuff, and they put a disclaimer saying sometimes stuff disappears, sometimes stuff doesn't work, sometimes stuff doesn't work the way it's supposed to, and just beware of that. Now, all of the different Google Labs stuff that I've used has actually worked pretty well. It doesn't always work exactly as they tell us here, but it does usually work pretty well. And it's so easy to enable and disable. This is all you do is if you want to use one of the tools, click on enable. If you decide that you don't want to use it after a little while, you can click on disable right within this menu. So it's really easy to enact it. You just have to make sure that you scroll down to the very bottom and save your changes at the very end. Now these are the current ones that are available. Now when you watch this video, there might be some different ones available than the ones that I have listed here. But the ones that are here some of them have been pretty stable for a long time. Now these are the three that I use and I like. One is create a document. One is adding a Google Calendar kind of a widget to my email so I can always quickly see my calendar. And the other is probably the most useful, undo send. Now I should point out, undo send doesn't actually, it's for when you click send and you have immediate sender's remorse. You go, oh shoot, I shouldn't have said that, because you see a typo going as it goes out, or you realize that you didn't finish the letter that you thought you'd finished. This allows you to quickly undo it. You have about a 5-second buffer to undo a send, and you'd be surprised how often you decide to undo a send after you send it. It doesn't go out in the internet and retrieve it. It stops it before it goes, actually, so it creates a little buffer for you. Let me show you how these things enact within my Gmail software, because this first one is a great example. It's create a document. It doesn't exactly work the way that it's shown right here in the promotion within the Google Labs area. Now that just might be because the way that I've got my screen set up in Gmail, I don't know, and I don't really care. It doesn't work exactly the same, but it does what I want. Here's how it works. I've got an email, and quite often as you're working on emails, you want to archive them in different ways, or you want to take the copy body of an email and you want to put it into a document. So rather than having to go copy and paste, how this works is if I use this tool here in a new window to reply to an email where I create that, I have the ability to create a document from that. So I'm not actually sending the reply there. I have to send a reply here by clicking on reply or the main reply button. But this allows me to open this in a new window first and then create a new document. When I create a new document, it creates a Google Doc, or now a Google Drive document, of all the content of that email. So it's a great way for you to archive or copy stuff into a document that you want to work on, save, do something with for a little bit later. The next tip that I would like to show you is the calendar, adding access to your calendar from right within your Gmail account. Now you can always, of course, jump back and forth into the calendar just through the menu bar by having another tabbed window open. But if you look way down here at the very bottom of my screen, we've got there a little click that allow me to open up the different gadgets in my sidebar here, and that is a real-time display of my calendar. Useful as you're going through emails, as you're adjusting time and working with people trying to figure out times for meetings and that sort of stuff. It's just a nice little simple addition that I think it's a no-brainer to incorporate within your Gmail software. And the third thing, oh yeah, the sender's remorse button. I enabled it, and now let me show you what happens. I'm just going to reply to the email that I created here. It's going to reply to myself, so if I mess up, it's no big deal. I'm going to click send. Now you have to watch quickly, because right here in the middle of the screen is going to appear my option for not replying or not sending this message. So I've written some pithy reply to something, I've spelt something wrong, and as I click send, I go, oh no, I made a mistake there. And look, right here, your message has been sent. No, undo it. And it now has not been sent, and I'm safe from embarrassment or possibly worse. a little bit of poking around in Google Labs is time well spent. Even if you just find one or two little tools that make your life a little bit more efficient, it is well worthwhile. Now, I hope that you think watching this video has also been worthwhile. If so, please give us some props, give us a like. We do appreciate that. And by all means, subscribe to the Dotto Tech channel. We release one of these videos per week at minimum, and we hope that you find them useful. I'm Steve Dotto. Thanks for spending time with me today.